Moving along, you guys have a brand new Legend Xtreme line this year that you introduced at the Classic, I believe, and then some new additions to that line. So if you could briefly just take us through the line in general and then the additions, that'd be fantastic.
You know, it was pretty remarkable to be involved with the process on Legend Xtreme. St. Croix being angler-centric, it's of high importance to us to hear and listen. And the fact we have control over the manufacturing process gives us a chance to be able to execute. And Legend Xtreme, as you mentioned, Joey, was launched at the Bassmaster Classic. It was designed to be the most sensitive fishing rod St. Croix has ever put on the market. And we have a machine now to prove it. It's really comprised of three main things, and I'm going to cover them here in a little bit of detail. Number one, the blank is it's St. Croix SC5 carbon, which is it's the highest strain carbon St. Croix works with, but this is a new form of carbon fiber for St. Croix. This is SC5 that was in the Legend Xtreme from last year. This is a new version of it. It's a purer form of carbon in conjunction with a new resin in the blank that this rod, long story short, is gonna recover faster from deflection. Okay, so it's increased in terms of flexural performance. What that means to the angler is gonna be more responsive. Okay, secondly, we married it with the Daiwa AGS guide platform, carbon fiber. So now you're talking about carbon to carbon. You can imagine with the advent of zero stretch braids and fluoros and all the lines that add sensitivity, this is a big deal going from here to here. And lastly, the handle, this is our second generation 2 Xtreme skin handle. I wish I could hand it to you and have you guys hold this thing. Because what we did this year, that's right, that's a long reach, man, but we'll give it a shot. But what we did is we applied a little bit of what's called raindrop, and it's a material that gives it just enough tack. But with regards to the handle itself, this is manufactured in Park Falls, guys, from the blank up. There's a urethane shim on the blank in accordance to the model. And then the material you're seeing here is actually an extreme skin material. It's actually applied. It takes days to make this. So it's not just folded over or heat shrunk at all. It's actually manufactured and built. So it's really going to be cool. Total 11 models in the series, and right off the top of my head in terms of the new additions, I would want to refer to my price sheet, which I don't have right in front of me, but we launched certain models at the Classic, and then we're launching more now to round out the series of 11 models. But this thing's USA built, SC5 carbon, Daiwa AGS guide platform, second gen extreme skin handle. Let me tell you this, I had this thing for a long time, and I had the guides on the SC5 blank to practice, not to, to test the prototype and so forth. And the first bite I had on this thing, I got a 20 mile an hour crosswind, Murphy's Law, the one day I get to test it, right? And I get a bite on a 3/8 ounce jig, and it felt like something flew into my line. You guys ever had a big dragonfly I've had a bat down Lake of the Ozarks do that at night. It's the best hit of the day when it happens. It's like, whoa, but I didn't pull the trigger. I thought it was something flying into my line. So I pitched out again to the same spot. It was a P.O. box, a little crotch of a tree, and boom, it hit it again. It was a real shocky type bite, and it is awesome. I mean, it's one of those, it's a level of feel and sensitivity that you have to fish to understand. I can't wait for you guys to try this thing.
You know, Dan, it's so interesting. We don't often get to talk to people that really know the rod building process from beginning to end. And there's not that many companies that go through the process of building their own handles, Corey. And I don't know if you've ever tried to build a rod. I've built some really rough and ugly rods.
You fixed a rod for me one time. It was pretty rough and ugly. You fixed that.
I did. I remember that. I fixed a rod for Corey, and it was terribly ugly. So I can't imagine the craftsmanship, the time, the patience, and the know-how that goes into making one of these new Legend Xtreme casting rods. And as you said, I mean, they're made right there in Park Falls, right?
Yeah. Well, and you're talking about, when you're talking about building a rod, you're starting with the blank. We're building the blank before you even start with the rest of it. So that's what, you tell you what we ought to do sometime, and I would invite all your viewers to this, is we're temporarily suspended right now on this, but we do factory tours. We have the largest United States rod manufacturing facility. A St. Croix rod company is family owned, and there's 32 sets of hands that handcraft every St. Croix rod before it gets to you and your viewers. And we'd love to have, you know, you guys come up and do a tour, and hey, you know, you two come up, we'll go jump on my boat and go crack on a bunch of smallies up here. That sounds kind of fun, huh?
I would say you don't have to twist my arm, but Dan and I have been trying to put this together for like 2 or 3 years. So I don't know, 2020 has been a weird year. Maybe 2021 we can plan on bringing the St. Croix factory experience to the Tackle Warehouse audience.
I say we make it happen. Remember, someone's going to have to film that stuff. So other Dan, cameraman Dan, he's going to have to be filming it. And I think he's probably going to do a little fishing, though, too.
You bet. So, Dan, that was the Legend Xtreme casting rods, a couple of new models there. Also, and I believe this is a new award winner, right? There was a couple of Legend Xtreme spinning editions. And did that just take home an award?
Well, Legend Xtreme won the freshwater category.
Got it. The whole line.
Yeah, it did, and we won it on. We were very blessed last night to find out we won Legend Xtreme and Mojo Inshore on the saltwater side.
Oh wow! Two
awesome.
Rods.
Congratulations on that.
Yeah. Well, you know, this is about you. I mean, this is one thing I would say with every confidence is St. Croix exists for the angler. Everything we do, we try to make the fisherman better on the water. So you guys are anglers too. You guys right there that I'm talking to, and all your viewers out there. So to win an award like that's a true blessing, because we know it's you that's the ultimate beneficiary. Winning awards like this does nothing but drive us to work even harder and do even more.
That's great. It says a lot about the company there, Corey.
For sure.
So, hey, Dan, can you take us through?